was left unturned to meet his desires.
Hey, Dad.
Hi, son.
Can I have the new iPhone 11? I want to be the first one in college to own it.
Why do you want an iPhone 11? Go Pro. I'll give you an iPhone 11 Pro. Here, take my credit card.
Thank you, Dad. You're the best.
It soon turned out that his doting parents fulfilled all his material needs, but failed to teach him values and principles which would hold him in good stead in the years to come. Charlton is often seen helping himself to the money in his father's wallet.
Dad's resting, and I really don't want to disturb him. But I really need some money to go out with my friends tonight. I think I'll take some from his wallet. He won't mind anyways.
Besides helping himself to his father's money, he also finds ways to cheat during exams. Cheating becomes second nature to him. If you are shocked by Charlton's behavior, let's find out who his role model was.
Hey, Dad.
Hi, son. How was your day today?
It was good. We had a test today, but I'm sure I did very well.
Oh, that's good to hear.
By the way, I have a submission coming up and I need some printouts. And also I need some money to buy some highlighters.
Why do you need to buy highlighters? Along with the printouts, I can get them from office. Nobody will notice. Let me know if you need anything else from the office.
Alright, thanks.
And so the boy grew. In the final B Pharma exam, through cheating and bribe, he obtained the required certificate and soon opened his own pharmacy. He did well for himself as he had several customers who came to purchase their medicines from him.
Oh, that was good business for the day.
Soon, Charlton got married to Samantha and had a boy of his own, little Daniel. Charlton loved his son very much. Like his dad, he gave Daniel everything. Daniel was a sweet-natured child and was loved by all.
Hey, let's go for a walk. Thank you.
there's a toy store over there. Daniel always wanted a remote control car.
Let's go check it out.
One day, little Daniel gets very sick and has high fever and vomiting. Samantha calls the doctor.
Hello, doctor. This is Samantha. Dr. Daniel is not well. He has high fever and he has no appetite. He's not been eating at all. Could you please come check him? Thank you, doctor. Dr. Daniel.
He has high fever, but given these medicines, I'll prescribe some medicines, he'll be alright.
Thank you, doctor.
Samantha decides to stay home and look after Daniel while she calls her friend and asks her to pick up the medicines for her from Charlton's pharmacy.
Hello, Shania. Shania, Daniel is not well and I need to get him some medicines. Could you please go to the pharmacy and get them for me? I would have asked Charlton to get it from our pharmacy, but he's not there right now. Thanks, Shania. Yeah, I'll send you the prescription by WhatsApp.
Hi, Samantha. How's little Daniel?
I don't know, Shania. I think I need to give him the medicines first.
Do you ask for? I'm sure he'll feel well after having the medicines. I am going now, but if you need me, you can call me.
Thanks, Shania.
Bye.
However, Daniel, instead of getting better, only gets worse. Daniel is rushed to the hospital. He is asked to be admitted to the ICU.
Dr. Daniel, Daniel is not well. He's not responding to the medicines.
He's really very hot. We need to rush him to the ICU immediately. He's not responding to anything. Please, take him immediately. Samantha, what happened to Daniel?
I don't know. I'm waiting for the doctor. Here he comes. Doctor, what happened to Daniel?
You really rushed him in the nick of time. I don't know what could have happened to him. With the medicines I had given you, he should have been fine. But we'll leave him under observation for a few more days. Don't worry.
Thank you, doctor.
How did all this happen?
I don't know. He wasn't well, so I called the doctor and he prescribed some medicines. I got Shania to get those medicines from our pharmacy. And I gave it to him. But they had no effect.
My pharmacy?
Yeah.
Our pharmacy shop?
Yes.
Oh no. He must have given her the fake medicines. In my greed to make a quick buck, I sold fake medicines to the people and cheated them. This almost cost the life of my son, who I love so much. God has given me and my family a second chance. This incident has truly opened my eyes, and I vow to change myself and become a better human being. Honesty is truly the best policy.